education, employment, migration and basic infrastructure. First of all, poverty. What is poverty? Poverty is the main cause of not having enough money to fulfill their basic needs like food, cloth and shelter, etc. And poverty is causing due to uneducation, unemployment and illiteracy. Due to poverty, many people and many children are suffering and they may not have good education, etc. And poverty has to decrease by the government by providing schemes like different schemes, and they have to provide not for employment. And here poverty can be decreased only if the people were encouraged or the people will believe the government. And here if we take as education, education is one of the most important part in our life. And education in rural areas, every child has been going to schools and it has been increased in going to government schools in rural areas. And in rural areas there is no basic infrastructures. And in schools, in my view, I have to say some points that which have to develop the schools in rural areas are providing innovative teaching methods and providing textbooks by providing textbooks and computer facilities and lab facilities, etc. And providing and establishing many schools, even though the private schools have been established, but many government schools have been providing many schools. In private schools, the fee is beyond the pocket of the people, and the parents will not suffer to pay the much fee for the children for the good education. So I'm here that government should provide free education and free employment and free secure job. And in India, till some people were living still in slum areas. Why the people were living in slum areas? Because they are believing superstitious beliefs and they are poverty and literacy. So it is our necessary that we have to educate them and we have to forward them to the our society. Many backward communities will also live in slum areas due to unemployment and some superstitious beliefs which have been believed by the others. And the government, for this eradication of slum areas, the government must provide security of jobs and the government must have perfect future planning for the slum areas. And if we take basic infrastructure in India, in rural areas, the basic infrastructure is far poor than if we compare to the other countries. And basic infrastructure such as hospitals and schools and road communication, road transportation system, etc. In India, around approximately 19,000 villages are not electrified yet. Even the villages which are electrified, they are not getting quality power. Here must understand that many villages are isolated with communication, and many villages didn't have road transportation system. For in that, people may face difficulties for transporting their goods, and in the case of health emergencies, they may not reach the hospitals clear at the time of the moment, and many people may die of going to the hospitals. And next, if there is no communication, the slum areas or poverty areas may not know the schemes which have been introduced by the government. 90% of schemes which have been introduced by the government are unknowing by the rural.